Hello everyone, welcome to Science Non-Science. I'm Prasanna Deshmukh and today we're going to discuss a very interesting topic, career in astronomy. And I've been planning to make this video from long time and now is the right time. Why? You'll get to know from this video. So we will be talking about very specific topic of career in astronomy with M.Tech PhD in astronomical instrumentation. Let's get started. So there is one very interesting course in India called as Integrated M.Tech PhD in Astronomical Instrumentation, and this course is conducted in collaboration with Indian Institute of Astrophysics and Calcutta University, as well as this course is also at ARIS, which is Aryabhatta Research Institute of Observational Sciences, and that course is also in collaboration between ARIS and Calcutta University. Now this is the Indian Institute of Astrophysics in Bangalore, this is ARIS in Nainital, this is Calcutta University, Kolkata, and this is one of the department of Calcutta University, which is called as Applied Optics and Photonics. And this course is conducted in collaboration with this department of Calcutta University. So whatever details I'll be giving in this video are taken from these two websites. So I will encourage you to go to these websites and check the details on your own. So about this program, this course is called as Integrated M.Tech PhD in technology, and it is in astronomical instrumentation subject, and it is in collaboration with Department of Applied Optics and Photonics, as I said. And this degree will be awarded by University of Calcutta, and you have to submit the thesis to University of Calcutta. And M.Tech coursework will be for 2 years, which is divided into 4 semesters. First 2 semester classes will be held in Department of Applied Optics and Photonics in Calcutta University. The third and fourth semester comprises of internship at IAA or ARIS based on where you are enrolled, and this will be at the field stations and the laboratories of IAA and ARIS respectively. And after completing the coursework of M.Tech and project of M.Tech, you have to opt for registration for the PhD Tech program at Calcutta University, which is of the duration of 4 years. So in total, this is a course of 6 years. So in order to be qualified for applying for this particular program, you need to be having qualifying degree, either MSc or integrated MSc in applied physics or engineering physics, applied mathematics, electronics, physics, or BTech from the recognized university in computer science, electrical, electronics, instrumentation, as well as mechanical engineering. So this mechanical branch was not eligible before, but from past several years they have enabled this particular option. As well as if you are BTech post BSc honors, then you can be from optics or optoelectronics background or radio physics and electronics background. So you need to have qualifying degree from any of these courses, and also some of the equivalent degrees, for example electronics and telecommunication, electronics and communication, are also eligible for applying for this program. Now the eligibility criteria is different for IAA or ARIS. So as I said, these are two parallel programs with similar content. So if you're applying for IAA, you need to have a qualifying degree. So in addition to qualifying degree, you also need to have a qualifying examination passed. For example, if you have qualified in JRF in the NET, CSIR or UGC exam after December 2018, or if you have 97 or more percentile in GEST examination, which is conducted after 2020, or if you have 98 percentile or above in GATE examination after 2019 GATE. So if you have any of these and your score is valid, then you are eligible for applying for this course. So mere meeting eligibility criteria doesn't guarantee you will get admission to this particular program. You need to meet some other criteria as well. So one of the admission criteria also requires a candidate to have scored more than 60% mark or above throughout the academic career, and candidate who have obtained their last degree, which is qualifying degree, which I mentioned before. If you have done it after 2017, then only you are eligible. Before 2017, if you have done that qualifying degree, you're not eligible. I will come to similar criteria for ARIS in few slides, which is slightly different. And age limit is also there. You should be 25 or less as on July 1st, 2021 for applying for IAS program. And how to calculate the percentile for GATE or JEST examination is straightforward, based on total number of candidates appearing for the exam and your All India rank, which will be there on your scorecard. So this is the formula for that. So this is a eligibility criteria for ARIS. Now ARIS, if you have qualified CSIR, UGC NET in physics, electronic science, applied mathematics, applied physics in 2019 or 2020, you are eligible for applying. And through GATE, if you have appeared for 2020 GATE or 2021 GATE, then you are qualified for applying if you have percentile more than 95%, which is slightly different than IAS criteria. Another important criteria is at ARIS, if you have 55% aggregate marks, then you are allowed to apply. Relaxation for SCST candidates, which is 50%. And then candidates who have obtained the last degree before 2019 are not eligible. So if you have last degree completed in 2019, then you are eligible at ARIS. And age limit is 28 years as on July 1st, 2021. So how is the admission process? Both the institutes have online applications open presently, and you have to apply separately for both the institutes if you want to be eligible for being considered for further rounds. And they will do initial screening based on your eligibility criteria, your qualification marks, and overall academic performance. And then shortlisted candidates will be called for interview. Also, you need to produce all the original documents and academic records, such as mark sheets, certificates, etc., whenever requested for. And interview will be held online for both the institutes as of now, as per their websites. Whereas for IA, they may consider to conduct interview in person in Bangalore. And for IA, in case of difficulty in holding the interviews, candidates will be selected based on their academic records. So that is one of the information which is also available on webpage. So there may not be any interview as well. And if you have any queries, they have provided these email IDs, so you can contact them on these email IDs for your further questions. So one of the important questions whenever we apply for different programs is how many seats are available for such a program. So there is no information directly available on IAS or ARIS website, whereas there is information available on Applied Optics and Photonics Department's website, and it says that there are 10 seats available, and this is only for the collaboration between Calcutta University and IAA. The course for Calcutta University and ARIS is new. This is the first year. That information is not yet updated, but I can imagine that there will be similar number of seats. So you have opportunity to apply for 10 seats at IA and 10 seats at ARIS Nainital, so which is very good, and you have double the opportunity as compared to the last year. You can also read the details on this website. Most important are the dates. Sorry for making this video a little late, but applications are open for both the institutes, for IA and ARIS. And for ARIS, 4th July is the last date, and for IA, 13th July is the last date. So if you are eligible, if you meet the criteria which I described in this video, do consider to apply if you are interested in doing M.Tech PhD in astronomical instrumentation. And interviews will be somewhere in the mid or end of July. As I said, this is a 6 years program, in which first 2 years you have M.Tech, for which you will be paid 20,000 rupees per month as a stipend. For the third and fourth year, it will be as a JRF, Junior Research Fellow, and you will be paid around 31,000 rupees per month. And SRF, it is 35,000. These numbers get revised whenever there is a revision of stipend at the national level. So, but presently these are the numbers, as well as you will also get benefits of hostel accommodation and medical facilities for yourself. So this is the coursework structure for the first 2 years, four semesters, and this is for M.Tech. And you will do different courseworks at Calcutta University in the first two semesters, and project work at IA and its observatories, or ARIS and its observatories. And presently the details of coursework are only available for IA. ARIS will soon upload their details on their website. So for your information, I was also a student of M.Tech PhD in Astronomical Instrumentation at IA, and I got admission in 2011. I completed this course and I got the degree for PhD. So This is a very interesting course. You'll be a person who knows astronomy as well as engineering. So that's the uniqueness about this particular program. And of course, you will do different projects. Some of the projects are listed on the IAP's website from their past students. So you can check on your own. Maybe details will not be visible here. So, but you can go to this website. So whatever details I have explained in this video are available on IAP's website, ARIES website, as well as Calcutta University's website. So do visit if you are eligible for applying for this program. Do consider to apply if you are interested. And the last date for ARIES, as I said, is 4th July, and for IAE it is 13th July. So hurry up and do consider to apply. And typically dates are in June, July every year. And this year it is 4th and 13th July for ARIES and IAE. As I said, this is a new program at ARIES. At IAE, this program is running from 2008. So it is very interesting to see now there are more opportunities for students who are interested in doing such a unique course. So yeah, do consider. If you have any doubts, they have provided the email IDs, as well as if you have any further queries, you can consider to ask them in the comment section. I'll be happy to answer as much as I can. And yeah, so feel free to ask questions. Do consider to subscribe to this channel. We come up with similar videos.